Richardson, though, is able to play it at Lindros, avoiding the check attempt by Redden. And Dackel will feel the wrath of Lindros. Oh, and Lindros hammered Dackel into the boards, and Dackel has not gotten up.
That's the hardest hit I've ever seen.
Oh, boy, he's cut badly. The arm did not go up from Richard Trotsche immediately.
Just absolutely overpowered Dackel. Watch this, finishing a check using the shoulder. And boy, Dackel was in a very vulnerable position. And right now, the Ottawa Senators are pleading for a penalty.
That one looked and sounded like a heavy hit, because it was. Dackel only 5'11". He felt the brunt of Eric Lindros right there. We'll be back.
The doctor has been escorted out to the ice. Dackel is still in that corner. You know, the factor is that Dackel is 5'11". Lindros is 6'7" on skates. You know, and so you know that he's going to tower above his opponent. But it all started at the blue line when Kravchuk tried to, or Redden rather, tried to hit him with a low hit, a hip check against the knees. Watch this. And Lindros just escapes that, and right now he is hot. And so he is out for bear and finishes the check, and Dackel never had a chance.
Dackel was slightly slumped, and the height disadvantage coupled with the fact that he was a little hunched over, and that meant his head is all that separates Lindros from the glass right there. That is a punishing check. The stick was down, the elbow was down. Unfortunately for Dackel, so was his head.
He had no chance in this play. He just had moved the puck up the wall, and coaches always say to a forward, you finish your check. And did he ever? So the cut was there, and I'll tell you, that is the most punishing check that I've seen in 25 years of hockey.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, you're worried about the cut, but obviously the concern also.
Manilik trying to wrestle him off the disc. Manilik has the puck, bounce free, got it back to the point, shot! Save right free by the score! Lindros ramming it home from in front, and the Flyers score in the first minute of the third. It's 3-2.
Well, if you're going to make a comeback, boy, why not start in the first minute of the period? And boy, Manilik did some great work behind the net. He refused to be knocked down, and the shot from the point got through, and the Flyers pounced on the rebound. But look at the work Manilik makes to get it to the point. And there's Lindros with his stick. I think he deflected into Rhodes and then picked up his own rebound. Maybe we can isolate a little bit. And boy, he just got away from his check, and it's a one-goal game. That's just good work. Manilik, and the shot got through, and Lindros following it up by stuffing it in the net.
Lindros' eighth goal of the year, and was into a tie. Thatcher from Morozov, checked by LeClaire, his pass just got through Manilik. Manilik and Wawrinka. Manilik centers it, LeClaire backhander wide. LeClaire to Lindros, tries to stop it, but he does! He scores! This line continues to hum, 2-0 Philadelphia.
Goal. I mean, very quick, there's no hesitation, reading the play, reacting to it, and Lindros has his ninth goal of the year. But what a play by not only Manilik, but also John LeClaire. Now watch how everybody is just to the side. Morozov just reacted very slowly to getting to Lindros, and he tucked it in very quickly. Now, here's the play. Stop it right there. John LeClaire, he sees Lindros to the side, and in one motion from the on his backhand, just moves the puck out in front.
2 points. He's now tied with Jaromir Jagr for points leadership.
He has certainly been on a roll, Eric Lindros. He's had a shot in every single game, and that makes eight games out of 12 that he has scored at least one goal.
We'll step aside, be back with more of the first period after this.
Type of hockey that the Flyers want from him.
Desjardins to Lindros. Lindros charging in. Lindros, the shot, he scores!
He fanned it.
A changeup beats Brodeur. Flyers lead it 3-1.
Now that's one of those bad goals that you were talking about that Brodeur has been giving up. And you got a happy, happy group of Flyer fans as they see one of the game's best let in a soft one.
But there's another example of why you keep shooting that puck at the net. But what a burst of speed by Lindros. He uses the skate to bump it up and then just lets it go. It didn't have a lot on it. And Brodeur just overreacted, had his stick off the ice, and went right through the five hole. So the Flyers come out charging in this third period and have grabbed a two-goal lead.
Duke pushes it out to Lindros. Lindros crisscrossing with Jones. Lindros holding on. They give him all kinds of room. He'll take it and score! Oh, you can't give Lindros that kind of room. Makes the Devils pay. It's 5-1 Philadelphia.
Not only did Lindros have time and a lot of skating room, but boy, he got some help from his wingmen, Jones and LeClaire, who went at the net. And anytime you go at the net, the defenseman has to go back and kind of converge. So Lindros had plenty of time to unload it. Watch this. There he gains the blue line. See now everybody back off, back off. And there's a slap shot that finds its way into the net. And John LeClaire was tippetoeing around that goal crease. He wanted to make sure he stayed out of there. The referee signified immediately that he was out of the crease. See John, look at him.
Eric Lindros with a four-point night.
The timeout is there to give the Lindros line a rest before they go to the power play.
John Macara is the McDonald's power play payoff contestant. $200 in the jackpot as Roger Nielsen uses the timeout to discuss things with his players. Milan, third minor of the game. McGillis moves into Desjardins. Perimeter passing so far. McGillis to Lindros in front. LeClaire, he scores! Tic-tac-toe, it's in the net! Power gets to the puck. Sundin wraps him up. Jones gets to it again. Walks out in front. Shots it. Rebound Lindros! He scores! Lindros picks up the garbage in front and the Flyers lead it 3-2.
Now this line has scored two goals. The distance has been about 2 feet. So the cycling pays off. They maintain control of the puck. They don't give it away blind. And eventually leads to a goal. But watch this given goal. And then Lindros all alone. He's on his backhand. He's got a man on him and still has the strength to overpower the check. Let's watch Lindros just hovering and gets a piece of that one. And in it goes. So Stevie Thomas was beside Lindros, but was not able to grab a hold or maintain the stick. And the line has come through again, this time the go-ahead goal.
Lindros had gone four straight without a goal. You could sense some relief from him as he...
EA Sports presents Cyber Lindros. In the game, it's in the game. NHL 99. EA Sports, it's in the game.
Cutting in the shots, and rebound, Lindros, he scores! Eric Lindros tucks it in. Power play goal, the Flyers lead it 1-0.
Yeah, goal number 13 for Lindros in the power play, and it all started along the wall, where a careless play by the Devils allowed the Flyers to maintain control of the puck. And they moved it around and Lindros finished it off. It starts right there. Now here's the shot. It goes back into the corner. Now look at Jones feed LeClaire again. And it caromed, I believe, off of Danico's skate, went wide of Brodeur. Here's Lindros now. He's going to come to this side. And there's the puck just waiting for him. And Brodeur, no chance on the play. So a good start for Philadelphia.
Eric Lindros, player who hesitates, got it back to Desjardins. Now McGillis, this shot blocked off in front. Lindros to it, the shot, he scores! Lindros' second power play goal of the night. And just like that, it is a one-goal game again.
You know, in the power play for the Flyers the last few weeks, other than the last two games, Lindros really wasn't involved in the shooting of the puck. He had control of it a lot. But you want this guy here to take a lot of the shots because of the way he can shoot it. But as it comes around, watch, just a shot at the net. Lindros is cruising. He's going to get the rebound and just fire it. See, now he's behind the net. He's just circling. All of a sudden he sees it, makes one move, and fires it. O-line not able to make the check, and Flyers are with
it. Going around it goes, Jones to the puck. Backhands to LeClair. LeClair for Lindros, he scores! Wow. Jones to LeClair to Lindros. We've heard that before. It's tied at one.
Well, that was a mismatch behind the net. Dennis Peterson had no shot at John LeClair. And when you get in there and forecheck, good things are going to happen. And that's been the strength of the Lindros line all year. Just a little dump behind the net. And right from this position, look at how John LeClair just digs it out. Peterson not even able to do anything to stop him. And then Lindros just moving right in and taking a one-timer. You know, it's on the play that Niedermeyer was looking behind the net at the pass coming in front. He never even saw Lindros until it was too late.